actually brings me, I'm glad you asked that question, because under this model with the second floor, and I don't know if you did this or not, because you said if it was two floors, it was $4 to $6 million for the construction, basically, for the cost. What if we made, if we didn't do, we had a third floor, but we only had half of a third floor. If we made it like a meeting space and then part of it was the outdoor space, how much does that change that $4.6 million to do something like that? So we don't do the residential portion to it. It's just basically the two floors. The third floor exists, but it's more of like a rooftop kind of space, and then maybe a meeting space.
Like receptions?
Kind of like receptions. So yes, for lack of a better word, we'll say we'll put receptions up there on the third floor where we can rent it out, so it could be somewhat of a revenue generator. Obviously not to the same degree as a residential, you know, apartments. But it leads me to Carl's question, because my question is because then it makes it much more of a municipal building, but it does have the component of the retail and everything on the bottom, as to what then would the value of that building be. So it kind of goes back to his, because I'd like to see kind of what it would be worth if we just did something like that. So it really becomes more of a building that is about the community more than it is a residential living at the top.
You just need a new line item that has a cost estimate for this open air.
Exactly, because I don't know how much of the, it would increase the cost from the four to six million.
$1 million, right?
Okay, I mean, I would kind of like, just out of curiosity, and then I'd be curious to see what kind of revenue it could generate. It's obviously not going to generate what, you know, a third floor residential is. But then I'd also like to know what the value of the building would be to someone if we wanted to sell it outright. Going back to Carl's question, because I would like to compare that with what if we had three floors and four floors. I'd just be kind of curious for a longer.
We should call this one the 2.5 floor.
Right, it basically.
Cost justification.
Wrench into your thing, sorry.
The cost justification for that's going to be a little more difficult, because you don't know in history, you don't take rate for something like that. So the revenue projection component might be a little too.
Yeah.
I mean, I would say you're just taking a flyer, and you can either say, you know, I'm way low, way high, or whatever. I mean, you don't know, but the thing that I'm fairly certain of, if you just build that open space, again, that limits, like a meeting hall or reception hall, that reduces the value to, generally, that reduces the value to the entire structure, because it limits the market for that, the marketability for that, and the retro of that. So, but the finish of that could be greater than the per square foot cost of your office space, depending upon what kind of flooring you put in there, acoustics that are associated with that, ceiling heights with that, and all those other things. But I mean, you can, again, that's why.
Yeah.
No, I'm in.
No, that's why. That's why I was just kind of curious, because I'd like to kind of have a. Because I agree. I mean, I don't think it would be as valuable, obviously. But.
Ken, would it be appropriate to assume that while there would be significant costs in doing that, the revenue would have to be calculated at zero?
I would.
Just because
I would, because you don't know.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
zero or close to. Because whatever revenue you bring in is going to offset some costs that you have to have just to provide the sewer.
Exactly. Right. It's a question of, would the city be running that? Would we have more staff? Would we contract that out, be paying someone to manage that? So, probably a lot of liability depending on what the space is used for, or whether or not alcohol or on the premises, that type of thing.
So, Ken, you got 2, 3, and 4. We've always been kind of charged, or I believe self-directed, to narrow down the choices here. Is a third floor option at all interesting to you if you were a Canada's place?
I'm not talking
about 2.5. I'm trying to reduce three choices down to two. So I guess my question is, I heard Pam's request, so I'm not discarding that, but if
based on... Oh, you discarded, I just was...
Based on what you've thrown up here on the wall, if you had to get from three choices to two, would you go the two and the four, or would you go the two and the three, or the three and the four? I'm just trying to get a bunch of choices down to something we as a CIC can take to the council so they can exercise this out in public.
It's all risk tolerance. Totally agree with that. And, you know, if I were the city manager here, I would say we're going to do four floors. We should do four floors because we're going to generate revenue, willing to take that risk, assuming that four floors are palatable here. If you can't do four floors, and again, I'm taking the size, the architectural size component out, because I know that hasn't been decided whether it's two floors, three floors, or four floors, but just risk reward, again, I would take the risk on the four floors to do that.
So aesthetics aside, you'd do a four.
But yes, but I probably would, you know, and again, if you include something out, I'd probably either go to the two or the four, probably.
Okay.
Thank you. One thing not being considered here is what the community actually wants the space to be.
Right.
And I understand the revenue generation part of it really well. We've done a lot of this kind of stuff. But the other piece of it is, what do you want out of this space? Pam's points are really well taken, because perhaps the community would like something else here. Maybe they don't want it to be a revenue generation space. Maybe they want to maintain part of the green space. A two-story building, I think, makes a lot of sense with a roof space, because it could be a community center, because it ties together the community. And that also brings in a lot of revenue. So as opposed to thinking about the building as a revenue generator itself, think about its impact on the surrounding area. So that's my point.
Well taken. I guess the only response to that is we constantly are under siege to not spend, you know, money and the funding of that. So that's the reason we kind of ran the 2, 3, and 4 scenario.
I think going to that is, that's where I think having the two options to go to council, because once it goes to council, we would set a public hearing instead. And then from there, because I am in agreement, we either, I think you do two floors or four floors. But I think as our recommendation, right.
2.5
Well, but my point is once it goes to council and the public hearing is set, they can then look at the 2 floors and we can get public input in terms of whether or not it is feasible to do that. So it's not really, maybe we don't want the 4 floors, but it's not necessarily just 2 floors. So I think I agree with Carl that, you know, we have to narrow it down. And if you're going to do that, I think you have to look at the revenue piece to it, which obviously is the 4 floors. But I also am very mindful of the fact that I am I'm mindful of the fact that this is a municipal building, and that it really does have to reflect. Revenue is great, but I think it also has to reflect what is going to fit best and what is going to serve the community as a whole, since it is a, you know, it is a taxpayer's building, so.
Well, and there's also another component to this whole equation. I don't know if this is a time or place to bring it up, but we've looked at this crunching numbers like we are a private enterprise looking at doing a project. And what I think we as a CIC have to at least understand, if not even notate to council, is that do we want to be in competition with the commercial people in this area that rent apartments, that have party facilities, reception type facilities? Do we want to compete with them being the city of Lowell?
I think, again, that's where public hearings are key, and I think that's where you're going to get more input from other council members, but I think the public is the key to that, because I think, and you have to look at it as the fact that four floors obviously is going to make us money.
And, very true.
And, yeah, so the point is that we have to find out, you know, which...
Well, let's go
which
back
is
to
more
the,
important
let's
for
go
the
back
public.
To the charge that we have as a CIC, and that is how do we get the highest and best use out of this property.
Exactly.
We're not here to, I understand, I don't want to talk out of both sides of my mouth, but we're not here to judge the competition aspect of it. We're here just to present what we found.
And I'm sympathetic, by the way, to this building. I walked it the other day. It's old. It's done. It's seen its best days.
Well, it's interesting, too, that you mentioned that, because if you go back to, this is not a new conversation.
Yeah.
This conversation goes all the way back to the 90s. And there was actually a safety task force at the time who looked at the facilities as well. And it actually said that it basically had a 10-year life. And that was back in the early 90s.
Yeah.
And basically their recommendation was that it would have to be completely repurposed or completely replaced.
Yeah.
So you know, that I mean, I think the idea that we can keep it in that, it's not feasible. So we have to find though what works long term from a revenue side, obviously makes sense from a financial side, but also what the public is really looking for. So
well, to your point on the highest and best use, well, that'd be a 50-story apartment.
Yeah.
So I'm just
yeah,
saying everybody should recognize the highest and best use.
Yeah.
There's the number side, and then there's the emotional side.
Right.
So
yeah.
somewhere in there. But I think our kind of mission is not to go to council with 40 choices. That
no.
Becomes
right.